you are wondering why Mr. Chidambaram did not wait for a few more days before appearing in public. Many people do it. You know the idol theft case in Tamil Nadu? The people who are accused stayed away from the police successfully for several weeks, even months. Nobody raised any question. But he held a press media conference and went home and was waiting to be for the law to take its course. And what did they do? They climbed the walls like monkeys. That nobody will forget it. They could have waited, they could have contacted them, they could have talked to his lawyers, they could have waited the next day. There was no danger of him fleeing. But they wanted to humiliate him. They wanted to show him as somebody who's wanted, who's evading the law. He was just inside, discussing it with his lawyers. He said he had spent the previous night, he had hardly slept the previous night, because as a lawyer, he was also, and as an accused, he was also preparing for what was going to be heard by the Supreme Court, which was denied to him. So this was the way I think justice was denied. This is an important fact in this case. But getting back to the point on the material, they do not have any material. And the grounds on which the Supreme Court of India, very unfortunate, this judgment, the orders from Justices Bhanumati and Bopanna, A.S. Bopanna, in that case, what are the conditions that are laid down when anticipatory bail is given? One is the person must be ready to appear before the investigating agency whenever required. One, the person must not, that means person must not flee the country or flee, avoid appearing before them. Two, you should not threaten or offer incentives to witnesses who can testify in that case. Three, you should not suppress evidence. These are the basic conditions, and applying it to the P. Chidambaram case, for which there is no basis at all, except the statement by two murder accused. There was no danger of any documents being suppressed or tampered with. No witnesses could have been threatened or persuaded to lie before the court. There's no such thing. He was not going to flee the country. He did not even avoid arrest for 2 or 3 days. And so I think it is a great shame that justice was not delivered in this case. And to make matters worse, and this judgment by the Supreme Court was not in the CBI case, because already they had arrested him, but in the case pressed by the Enforcement Directorate. On that point also, the lawyers tell us the Enforcement Directorate comes in only when there are proceeds of crime. No money trail has been traced here, other than what the statement says. No details are given. They claim they have sent letters rogatory.